the war is reaching out and
angry. More sleep that count sheep and have another night of bliss. Across from the bus barn in Wasilla now is where we is. Save more bucks at the mattress ranch.
We all know how a dog reacts when he sees something he really likes. Unexpectedly, I've noticed the same behavior on this young man. Can you turn this into something good?
Skunk, I'm the bassist slash like schizophrenic slash illegal because I exist.
Hi.
I'm Miller, I sing, I'm terrible at singing.
He's the alcoholic.
Alcoholic, and we're all obsessed with serial killers.
No, we're not. Just
me.
Oh God, Isaac, you said you were obsessed with cereal?
Yeah, there's some apple jacks over
there. Cinnamon Toast Crunch, you know, I get a bowl and fill it with my own milk.
That just sounds like ill behavior.
Anyways.
I'm Red, I play lead guitar, and I'm a student at University of North Florida.
Nice.
I'm Giacomo, I play the drums, also a student at the University of North Florida, and I'm crazy.
So y'all are like relatively new. How did y'all begin?
So me and Red had met at this one band meet. but we really didn't like the direction it was taking. And me and Skunk too had already been in a lot of processes and trying to start up bands that we wanted to start up because we were really happy with our local scene. And it wasn't even the local scene, it was just music that we wanted to play. And it's not bringing back any kind of old school style or new school style. It's just the style that we want to play.
Because we are original.
Yeah, we're very original. But so I hit up Brad and, you know, I was like, let's start a band. Let's do this, you know, let's make the music we really want to start. And then, you know, I think Rick can take from here about how we started.
The original lineup, I was supposed to play drums, Skunk was supposed to be the vocalist, I think you were supposed to be the bassist.
Yep.
Like, pretty much the way the lineup is now, it was just entirely reversed, and all the pieces just kind of fell in place. Eventually, we met Giacomo here,
yeah.
Talented drummer.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. I wound up playing guitar, and Miller here's been our vocalist ever since.
And I play bass.
That's Skunk plays bass.
Yeah, bass.
What? I play bass.
No, I don't. You're lying.
Now you've been like learning to play bass since joining this band, haven't you?
Yeah, I was. Miller just handed me his bass because I couldn't like do shit.
I was
like,
just
play.
Like, just
and then
play.
I ripped the fattest. You heard of Pharrell? I'm like Pharrell, but on bass.
Yeah, I handed him the bass, and because, you know, some people can do the whole vocal performance, and some people, you know, they have the idea for it, but they can't do the stage performance for it. And Skunk had all the right credentials, better than me. I'm telling you, he could. If you see him at local shows, he can scream his ass off. And I handed him a bass and I was like, play something. And he was like, what do I play? I'm like, just fucking strum it.
I hope you're cool with this bit I'm doing. I'm just gonna
We
love his feet.
We love his feet. Yeah, I'm just gonna do a toe reveal.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure all the Quentin Tarantino fans out there would really appreciate it.
But it's like after each question. So like after the next question, I'll remove
you get
one sock.
Toe.
That's
say
our
hi
original.
To the audience. Yeah.
Oh, hi.
That's our original drummer.
He passed away. Yeah, he passed
away. Yeah, I'm dead.
Triple car crash.
Supposed to be in war right now. But he got shot at and died in like 17 car crashes.
Yeah, the car crashes.
And then God saved him.
Yeah. Yo.
Ill behavior is gonna slit your wrist.
No, we're not.
We're
a completely
family-friendly band,
except for children.
All right, how would y'all describe y'all's creative process?
I don't know. I just showed up, and they just taught me songs.
We mostly just jam at rehearsals. We'll pick a few chords, you know, play around with them for a little bit, you know, try a couple of drum beats, and Miller will just kind of improvise some vocals. And if we have a flow that we think sounds all right, we'll write it down and we polish it off and we keep playing it until it sounds good.
Yeah. I mean, our original sound, what we were going for, is just straight up punk. But then we realized we didn't really want to do anything that was old school, because who wants to bring back old school stuff? We just want to play it the way we want to play it, because we weren't happy with the music that was coming out. So we just...
It was all like hardcore music at the when we started, and then what was it? I noticed that a lot of stop looking at my toes, Vance. Anyway, I noticed a lot of the like punks ended up being taken over by the hardcore scene, and it was just kind of a soup of different people.
Yeah. And me and him were just like, we're kind of. Me and him were very tired of that scene because it's just not something that. We fit into. We can get in there and have a lot of fun, but it's not something that's for us. And we wanted to make something that was for us.
I wish one of you motherfuckers is a real jackass. Huh? How many of you motherfuckers are trying to fucking system, huh?
You're a slut!
One practice, Jock introduced us to like some other music thing he had on SoundCloud, and I called it Wormcore.
Wormcore.
He's the original pioneer of Wormcore. And
if I had the set list, I would bring it up.
Yeah, our idea was we're gonna throw like compost into the crowd and hide the amps underneath the dirt so people get to lay down and feel the vibrations.
Feel it.
And then a thing, you know what worm calling is? You take like two sticks, one rub one stick on the other, and worms just crawl up the ground. That's our like crowd thing that they get to do because it's cool.
So what's the next question?
Schizophrenic.
What are your favorite songs that y'all have done?
I like POV into the slowdown just because I like playing that the most. It's funny, going back to kind of like bleeding questions here, I didn't really listen to a lot of punk before coming into this band. I just showed up and I knew how to play the drums and said they liked me.
Yeah.
But
there's a joke because he knows how to play like jazz.
Yeah.
We call it chill behavior.
Chill
and he just
behavior.
Does like jazz. I play a stand up bass and then, yeah.
Chello. But yeah, I like POV because it slows down. It's a kind of, like they said, it's sort of hardcore, but not really. I take a lot of hardcore influence.
Because he's so cool, like,
because I'm cool. But yeah, I like that song the most.
I'm a little biased since I'm the one that wrote it, but I like playing Leather Leash. Just like that riff for Leather Leash was like kind of heavily Bad Brains inspired. You know, I take a lot of influence from Bad Brains, and the lyrics for it was actually inspired by something that I'd read about in one of my classes, one of my UNF classes, Terrorism Today. They talked about this thing called propaganda by the deed, in which terror groups will commit an act of violence so that a government will adopt tyrannical security measures. And in doing this, they kind of get a chance to point a finger at the government and say, see, I told you they were tyrants. And that's kind of what the song's supposed to be about. It's supposed to be about how, you know, when you have things like terror attacks, gang violence, just general crime, it increases animosity amongst the people. It increases animosity amongst the proletariat. So that's what that song's about. It's about somebody trying to get revenge against society for being discriminated against, but becoming exactly what society says they are. Aside from that song, I love playing Traction. Like the opening riff, you know, it has like a real surfy sound to it. And I mean, that's just my thing. I love surf rock. I mean, The Frights, it's one of my all-time favorite bands.
Oh, yeah.
So, I don't know, anything surfy. Traction, that's gotta be my favorite.
Can I just ask,
No, you cannot.
To just bust one move?
Down
down the line.
We'll do it after the episode.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess there were a lot of, like, there were a lot of songs that kind of influenced, you know, our sound. But my favorite song that we ever did was just fucking probably Teenage Communist. Not because it's, like, my favorite song that we play, but more of when it started. Because, like, that song just name-dropping ill behavior in there, that ill behavior is such a risk that represents all of our attitudes. Because we all had, before we even started the band, we all had reputations in the scene.
Not me.
Speak for yourself.
I'm an upstanding citizen, man.
I'm chill as hell.
I didn't say bad reputations, but we all did have reputations.
That's true.
A lack of a reputation is a reputation.
Yeah. I didn't say bad reputation, fucking everybody.
Teenage Communist was written spur of the moment, wasn't it?
Yeah. That was a freestyle. A lot of our songs were freestyle when we first started.
Yeah, that's like me on the drums, man. I just whip up a new beat every time, I'm gonna be honest.
And then there's another beat. Anyways, my favorite song, also because I wrote it, because I'm just like Red, I'm not original at all. is Paranoia. Not Paranoia. What the fuck?
Propaganda.
Propaganda.
You're the one who wrote it.
Shut up.
You mean Paranoia.
Schizophrenic activity. I actually wrote that song. I wrote that song as I was thinking of a paranoid schizophrenic watching like. Yeah, okay. So, the song is like partially inspired by a game called Cyberpunk because they have floating ads. Like,
oh yeah.
Yeah. And I'm like, what if like a homeless paranoid schizophrenic looked up and seen that? And I'm like, damn, that'll suck. So, I made the song, and at the time, I think I was listening to BYOB by System of a Down, because I remember I wrote a lyric saying, you can join the party if you come from poverty. And in BYOB, I think it's Surge, he's talking about fucking how military recruiters, they come to low income areas and recruit teenagers, which is super fucked. And then they kind of romanticize war as something cool, something awesome. You go there, have a great time. You come back, don't get any benefits. Kind of just throw you into the street. And there was another line in it where it was personal. I hate it when people indulge themselves in a fucking, like, celebrity lives. Like, Keeping Up with the Kardashians. That show was a nightmare, because who cares what they're doing?
Who cares about reality TV?
Exactly, they're just people. That one was also sort of inspired by Cyberpunk, because Keanu Reeves, he hates photography. You know, people coming up to him and be like, hey man, I need your signature, I want to take pictures. Shit like that. Kind of dumb.
No, I fucking love it. Come up to me, man. I'll fucking advertise anything.
If you come up to me,
give me my fucking money.
I got a lot to plug.
I'm gonna be honest, like, I'm cool with interviews and shit, but if you come up to me in my normal day-to-day life with a camera in my face, I'm biting the camera and breaking it.
Oh, chill out, dude. You played three gigs.
I don't care. It's like a huge pet peeve to me.
Alright, I'll shout you out on Instagram, just
for
people to come
on the gram.
I will.
Yeah, you want to make a real reputation, come up and just fucking take a fucking picture, man.
Yeah.
Go ahead, just take
I'm cool with that.
Pic.
But
yeah.
If you're, I'm cool with that, but if you're coming up with a camera in my face asking, like, questions, trying to interview me while I'm in Winn-Dixie, I'm gonna kill you.
No, do it in Winn-Dixie. I fucking hate that place. Especially fucking Walmart.
We're getting on a hot tangent here.
We are getting on a tangent here.
Yeah,
all
right,
That song, and then, POV is also one of my favorite songs. And my favorite cover is The Witch.
The Witch is
because I picked it because it was reminding me of my girlfriend.
No!
Thank you.
hamburger.
What food would you fuck up right now?
Shit. Just about anything, really. I'm hungry. I'm so fucking hungry.
Some Chinese food, you know, fried rice, a little bit of teriyaki, maybe pancit.
Miller gave me. That last night, actually.
Dude, I want some lumpia, chicken adobo with some pancit. Fuck that shit up. And crabs.
Like Red said, dude, this Mexican food truck that's right near his place, dude, that shit is fucking amazing.
I would get a burrito right now.
Why do y'all love performing?
Olivia, if you find Kalia, see if she's cool with what helping you, alright?
I would say I like performing just because I haven't, this is like my first time at a real venue. We did a house show not too long ago, and that was super fun.
It was at a Hello Kitty party.
Yeah.
We got there, and what was it? It was so fucking weird. Everything was pink.
Not informed at the time. We crashed the shit. We played the shit. We hyped the shit. And we also proceeded to get kicked out of the shit.
Somebody had to kick over the shop.
Well, somebody had to get drunk, huh?
I love the feeling of performing live. You know, something just kind of takes over, takes control. I can't even describe it. I just feel different. I'm addicted to that feeling. So, you know, I gotta perform live.
He actually does a line of coke before we go on stage.
That's the magic feeling.
That's why we got kicked out of the party, man. Cocaine is real.
I'd say I like performing. One, because we're playing, because, like, punk and shit is my favorite. Two, just fun to be on stage. Especially when, like, what was it? Our first show was at Shantytown. We had a bunch of our friends come in, and they were just hyping us up. I love playing with our friends in the crowd.
Yeah, that's amazing.
It's getting on stage and just saying what you have to say.
That too.
In my opinion, when you're playing punk rock, you get up on stage, you shout your lyrics, and you shout with meaning. Because if you're not saying what you mean, then what are you doing? You know, if you don't have a message to say, and you're not saying it, then you're not living.
Holy shit, that kid's doing a coffin.
Oh, yeah, man.
I'll be like, eat shit.
You know, cause in like everyday life, man, I don't get to say fuck you to everybody.
That's true. I can.
You know?
I do.
Skunk don't give a fuck.
I actually do.
But regular generosity, it's like, you gotta, you know, twitching.
Twitching.
A lot of tweaking makes me the man I am.
Tweaking?
Ooh.
Alright, we're done.
Cut that out. We can't have that before Feet Finders.
No.
Anyways, I just had to fix my shit.
There was a lot of shit we had to fix. And that's before the Spikes came and the van came and all the
money. Don't know what he's talking about.
What are we talking about?
I don't know.
I'm talking about fixing my pants.
I have no clue.
I'm talking for future
in the show. The shows are fun.
They are very fun. Yeah. I have fun.
Alright, three more questions. I've been meaning to ask this, by the way. What does ill behavior, like, where did that come from?
So we were kind of arguing amongst ourselves over what we wanted the name to be.
He takes a Lies and Deception at UNF.
Took Lies and Deception.
He took Lies and Deception. We kind of just, like, we put a card in the book, opened it, first word we seen was ill behavior. And we're like, well, that's a cool name. We kept it.
The name also has a meaning, just like the lyrics.
Just like the lyrics. Yeah. One day we're gonna come out with a really random song. It's just gonna be like
Worm
Core.
Get ready for that show.
Stay tuned. Get ready. Next show we have Worm Core guys.
Next show.
We're gonna invite a bunch of worms.
I know, guy. And last question. Any last words you have for the viewers up there?
Don't pee your pants.
Yeah, that's bad.
Kill it. Don't die. Because Jack Steel will fucking kill you if you're not careful.
Time flies like an arrow. Fruit flies like banana
bars.
Okay, wise
bars.
Words of Jock.
Wise words.
That's what I leave you with today. Amen.
My words is.
No one asked
be
you.
Be chill, guys.
Hey, don't clap yet. We got one. Oh, we got some new shit.
Oh shit.
Skunk here is gonna teach you motherfuckers how to mosh. Oh, and one more thing. Happy birthday, Hannah! Get a fucking drink! Hey, fucking, let's fucking do this shit! Let that shit on run, Jacksonville! Let that shit on run!
Holy shit, it's not fucking shit! Let's go and shit! You're fucking- plenty of other fish in the ocean. If you like fish,